Right. So having a click track for your live performances is extremely useful, unless you have a song where there's drums or other percussive elements going on all of the time. If you have some sections without drums, you still need to be able to play in time, right? So you need a click track. Now, the problem is you don't want your audience to hear the click track, right? So you want to have two separate mixes, one with just the music you're playing that's going straight to the speakers facing the audience. And then you want to have a separate mix for your own headphones, maybe, where you have the music you play plus the click track. So how do you go about that? Well, traditionally, you would have to buy a separate sound card with multiple outputs. So you could have, say, outputs one and two, send your stereo mix straight to the speakers, to the audience, and then outputs three and four, having both the music and the click track going to your headphones. But if you're in a situation like me where you do everything in the box, you only use soft synths, you don't have any microphones, any guitars, nothing at all. Can you really justify purchasing a separate sound card just to have the click? So you're telling me I would have to purchase a sound card and an expensive one at that as well, because it has to have that extra number of outputs just to get my click track. Come on, give me a break. Now, is there an alternative solution? And I've been thinking, well, to solve that output problem, I could get a metronome app on my smartphone, right? So Ableton wouldn't have to take care of the metronome. It could, send the audio, the music I'm playing straight to my only output, right? I only have one stereo pair of outputs. And then I could just plug in my headset straight into my phone and have the metronome be handled there, basically. But that has two problems. Number one, you would need to launch your first scene or start playing in Ableton perfectly in sync with the metronome. So imagine this scenario. You start the metronome, click, click, click. And then you have to launch your first scene perfectly in time with that click. If you press that launch button just a couple milliseconds late, it's going to be very annoying to continue for the rest of your live show, because there's always going to be that slight delay, which, can really impact your performance. So that is the first problem. But even then, let's suppose you're a robot, actually. You manage to perfectly launch your scene in time with the metronome. What about if you have multiple songs on your live set, right? Suppose you have the first three or four scenes at 120 BPM, but then you fade into your next song, which is maybe at 80 BPM. So what are you gonna do? You're telling me that you're gonna set the new BPM value on your app while playing live. Come on, give me a break. That's not a viable solution, right? So we're in a bit of a conundrum here, right? Because if you use a metronome app, you solve the output issue, but you have the sync issue, right? Where if you change BPMs during your project, that change won't be reflected on your metronome. Whereas if you were to only use Ableton, you could use Ableton's built-in metronome, which is great because that will solve the sync issue, right? In fact, let me just quickly show you what I mean. So I have three clips here, three different scenes. I can make my track a little larger here so that we can reveal this scene tempo option. And let's just type in some random values. Let's make it 90 BPM for my first scene, 150 for the second one, and maybe let's go back to 120 for the third one. So I activated Ableton's metronome. So if I launch my first scene, notice how the BPM value went to 90. Then if I launch my second scene, it's now 150.
If I launch my third scene, it's back to 120. So that is all well and good, but the problem remains that the audience would hear that metronome as well. That's the problem. If we use Ableton's metronome, we have the sync benefits, but we get the output problem as well. If we have a separate app on our smartphone, we have the multiple output benefit, but we lose the sync benefit. So if you want to solve this, we need to get the best of both worlds, right? We need a separate app so that we can solve the output problem, but then we need that app to somehow sync to Ableton, just like Ableton's internal metronome would. And luckily, there is such a solution. So let's go online. Right there. So Link is basically sort of a protocol that Ableton have created a couple of years ago, maybe. So it's fairly recent, and it allows for multiple devices or pieces of software to be synced together. So problem solved, right? We just need to find a metronome app that supports Ableton Link. And luckily, as you can see here, they have a list. As you can see, there is a lot of stuff here. There is some hardware, some software, and you can even filter by type. Now, I don't see metronome here as an option, so I'm just gonna command F and type in metronome, and let's see what we got. So, boom, there is an app already. But as you can see, it's only available on the App Store. And if you're an Android guy like me, then you're out of luck. So we're gonna have to switch to the next option. Okay, there we go. The Metronome by Soundbrenner. Doesn't say download on the App Store, it says learn more. So as you can see, it's available on Google Play as well. So I'm just gonna grab my phone.
So this is what it looks like. You have a couple different panes here. You've got your player, which shows you the current BPM value. You can change that, but you don't even need to bother with that, right? You can go straight to settings, app settings, all the way down towards this Ableton link. And as you can see, it's already set to on in my case. I have zero links going on because we need to set this up in Ableton as well. So let's get back to Ableton. Now we're going to press Command comma to open up our preferences. As you can see, mine are already on the link tempo MIDI pane here. And here are your link options. So show link toggle. Of course, we want to set this to show. Boom, there it is on the upper left of the screen. And also we want to enable start stop sync. And what that does is whenever you press play in Ableton, it will start the metronome. And whenever you press pause, it will pause it. So honestly, I have no idea why you would not want to use this option, but you know, I just wanted to show you how to enable it. So we're all good to go here. One last step. The two devices you're going to connect through link need to be on the same network. Easily solved. You just create a hotspot from your phone. You don't even have to have data enabled. You just need both devices to be connected through Wi-Fi. So I just created a hotspot and my laptop is connected to that hotspot. So that's it really, right? So my phone already has Ableton Link enabled. It's waiting for any possible connection. So the moment we press Link here, watch what happens on my phone screen. We got that little notification, one link. So my two apps are now linked. You can see this kind of yellow bar moving. That is actually how long it takes at 120 BPMs for one bar to, you know, happen. So at any moment within this time window of one bar, we can launch our scene. Ableton is going to wait for that one bar period to be over, and then it will actually launch the scene and our metronome will start as well. So let me deactivate Ableton's internal metronome. Actually, let me switch to the player pane so that we can see both in Ableton and on my phone how the BPM value changes. I'm going to launch my first scene here, which as you can see is set to 90 BPM. So the moment I launch it, Ableton is going to wait for that one bar to be over, and then it's going to launch the scene, and the BPM value will change here, but it will also change on my phone. So here goes. I don't know if you could hear that, but the metronome was playing back its click track at 90 BPM. Now let's switch to the second scene, which is at 150, and watch what happens. Brilliant. Let's launch the third scene as well to go back to 120. Brilliant. So problem solved, right? One last thing I wanted to mention, and this might not even be an issue for you, but it was for me. So I want to show you how to solve it if you encounter it. So let's run this little test. Let's activate Ableton's metronome and let's hear if it's actually perfectly in sync with the app or if there's any delay between the two. Here goes. Kind of okay, but I feel there is kind of still a little delay, and that is caused by the processing latency of your phone. And luckily we can compensate. We just need to go to app settings, and down here it says audio latency offset. So as you can see, I had set this to minus 25 already, but actually let's reset this and let's have a listen. That works better, right? I guess I shouldn't have set it to minus 25, but you know, whatever. If it doesn't work, you can just use this slider. To, you know, find the perfect balance so that the click in Ableton and your actual click on your phone are perfectly in sync. And once you've done that, you can disable Ableton's metronome, of course, and be good to go.
So there you have it. This way you really get the best of both worlds. Your separate app on your phone, you can just plug your headphones into your phone and have your metronome, and you're gonna be the only one hearing it. And Ableton can send all of its audio, whatever you're playing live, whatever you're launching, straight through the speakers facing your audience and you only hear the music and not the click track. So if this was helpful to you, let me know. If there's anything that is not clear that you would like some further explanation on, leave me a comment. I'll be happy to elaborate further. And yeah, that being said, don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you on the next video in about 2 weeks time from now, as always. Take care.
Believe in ghosts, Beth?